How do you do, guys? Welcome to today's edition of Programming Users TV. In this class, we're going to continue with our WxPython tutorial. Okay, so in this case, we're going to look at text fields, labels, and buttons. Now, as you can see right here, I can, for example, come and type something here, and then I come type here, and then if I click get right here, you can see it gives us all this one right here. Okay, for example, I can come and have my spacecraft as pizza. Then I can come have the propellant as laser beam. Then if I click get, it tells me pizza uses laser beam. Now if I come click set, then it resets them Cassini and nuclear energy. So if I come get, Cassini uses nuclear energy. Basically what you are looking at, we are looking at how to get and set values to a text field, and that also how to handle the button click of our buttons in WxPython. Okay, so the WxPython, this is what you're looking at. So if I come right here, click get, you can see the data we've typed at runtime, we're able to get it. It's a very simple tutorial, but very crucial for us to be able to understand how to work with WxPython to create our GUI applications. Okay, so let's get started. So go ahead, create a project in whatever IDE you're using or editor. We only need this one Python file, main.py. So first and foremost, we'll come right here and import our WX package as well as the wx.xrc. Then we're going to come create a class called myapp. As you can see, this myapp class is deriving from the wx.app. Now this is what will make this myapp a WxPython application. So we come right here, and then we're going to listen to the onInit. Now onInit is right here a function that will actually be invoked when this particular WX application is invoked, is actually run. Okay, so if we run it, this onInit is the first function that will get executed or invoked. Now as you can see what we're doing right here, first you're instantiating a frame right here. We come and say self.frame equal to new. Now this Mr. Frame is a class that we're going to create shortly. Now we're passing it none right there. Okay, so we assign it to the frame property of the instance of this my app. Then self.setTopWindow, then self.frame, we pass the frame of course as our top window. Then self.frame.show, then we're going to show it, then we return true. So this one right here, we do them inside the onInit function. Then we'll come and then create that frame. Okay, this is going to give us a WX frame. As you can see, class Mr. Frame, then we import or we extend the wx.frame right there. Now having done that one, we're going to have our init method right here. As you can see, it's taking in a self, okay, and then of course the parent right here. Now we'll come and then invoke the init function of the our frame wx.frame. We're going to pass it that this particular self, which is actually the instance of this particular Mr. Frame. Then we'll pass it the parent and then the ID. Now for the ID, we're going to just pass it wx. We're not assigning it any specific ID, so we just use wx.id any. Then we pass it a title, the title of the form or the frame. Then the position, we'll use the default position. WxPython is going to figure for us the position. Then for the size, we'll come wx.size, we specify the size of our WX frame. Then the style right here, wx.default frame style, and then as you can see, we specify our style there. Now having added that one, we'll come set our size hints, then we'll set the background color. As you can see, this is the background color I'm using. Then we'll come instantiate the wx.gridSizer. Then we'll come and then have right here a static text, which I'm calling my name label. As you can see, I'm giving it the text name. This is just the label. Okay, and then once we have it, we're going to add that particular label to our gridSizer. Then having done that one, we'll also come and then instantiate a text control, our wx text control, then we're going to pass it at these parameters, including the text right there. Now this is the default text is going to have. Then we're going to add it also to our grid sizer. We're going to have another static text called propellant, then we assign it some text, then we're going to also add it to our grid sizer. Then we'll come and then have our propellant txt, which is a text control. We give it some default text, then we'll also add it in our wx grid sizer. Now having done that one, we're also now going to instantiate a wx button, then give it some text right here, as you can see, get. Then we're going to add it also in our wx grid sizer. Then we'll come and then do the same thing with our set button, also add it, and then we'll come and come self.setSizer. Remember, self in this case refers to the instance of this particular Mr. Frame, which is actually inheriting from our frame. So setSizer, we pass it the grid sizer, then set layout right there. Then we come, we're going to self.center wx.both. Then now we need to listen to the events. Okay, we want that when the button is clicked, we're going to get the values. When the set button on the other hand is clicked, we'll set the values. So self.getBtn.bind, we invoke the bind. Then as you can see, the event type is the event button. Then we're going to be binding this get values. Get values is a function that we'll create in a short while. Now for the set button, the same, we pass in the event button and then the set values right here as the function, which is going to be our event handler. So we're going to come now and then create those particular virtual event handlers. The first one is the get values, which we're going to bind to our get button. So this is our event handler. Is going to, when the button is clicked, this is what we'll do. We're going to show a message box that will have the value of the name text control and the propellant text control. We'll show them in a message box. On the other hand, when the set values, when the set button is clicked, we're going to set a new value to our text control and a new value to our propellant text control. Then we're going to come right here, instantiate our app, and then run the app right here by invoking the main loop method. Having done that one, then we're just going to come right here and run. Now as you can see, the app is working perfectly. If I come, for example, right here and have this one, okay, then I come have it right here. If I come click get, you can see I'm able to get. If I click set, it will reset the values. So we come right here and I can give it a propellant right here, and if I click get right here, you can see we're able to get this particular value. So guys, this is it. This is what we've looked at right here, wx python text fields and buttons. Like the video, share it, and stay tuned. We'll continue doing more wx python tutorials. Take care. I'll catch you in the next class.